Praise the Lord, our beloved viewers. I trust that the week has been good and awesome. And once again, this is the day the Lord has made that we may be rejoicing and be glad in it. We are so glad that you have found time to be there this evening. Some of us are in the morning, others are in the evening. Doesn't matter the time that you are in. What is very, very important, it is to hear the word of the Lord. And by this word, we'll be set free. And I believe that the time that we have, the short time, we'll be able to share a very important message for all of us, whether you are married or not, you know, in family, doesn't matter. We are going to share a very important word, and the Lord gonna bless us in Jesus' mighty name. So from wherever you are watching, some of us I know are in Nairobi, all the way to the 47 counties of this nation. In Africa, Germany, wherever you are, Karibuni sana. We are happy that you waited for this, and we are glad that we are going to learn something very important, all of us together. And before we continue, we're going to make a short prayer, and then we move on in Jesus' wonderful name. Our Father and our God, in Jesus' name, I want to thank you because of this broadcast tonight. Thank you because, God, you are about to speak to somebody. And I want to thank you for your word. The Bible says that you sent your word, and your word healed them and delivered them from every destruction. Through the word that is going to be shared on GSF, our platform tonight, may you heal somebody. May you deliver somebody. May you set someone free. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray for all our listeners, all our viewers, that the grace of God, it will be multiplied in your life in a great way. And as we learn together, we are going to grow in our relationship, in our marriages, to the glory of God. In Jesus' name, we pray and we believe. Amen.
And amen.
Yes, thank you. The Lord bless you so much and do you good. Amen.
Yes.
Well, this is Global Strong Family Network, and our mission, of course, is healing, aiding marriages globally. And in case you are listening to us for the first time, there are a few things I'd want to remind you. Number one, we've got our Facebook page. The one you can view us with right now is called Twatwa, Pastor Sue Munene. Twatwa, Pastor Sue Munene. You can like, comment, share, you know, do all that. Follow that page. And tonight, especially in the one we are talking tonight, I would wish that you share with somebody somewhere, and the Lord will bless you. That is Twatwa, Pastor Sue Munene. Then we have got our YouTube account, which is Pastor Sue Munene Official. Pastor Sue Munene Official. We want you to subscribe to our account. We want you to press the notification bell so that you can get to know when we upload some of the teachings in that account. And maybe you can tell us some of the teachings that are in our YouTube account.
Yeah, there are quite a number of them about the Word of God. If you want to grow in the Word, we have all that teachings. If you want to grow in your relationship, about sex, about in-laws, about anything that concerns marriage is there.
Amen.
So it's quite a rich YouTube channel.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
To God be the praise.
Amen.
Now, today is a great day because we are talking about causes of lack of Twatwa in marriage.
In marriage.
You know, causes of lack of sex or Twatwa in marriage. That is what we are talking about.
There are quite a number of
yes, actually, there are so many. We cannot exhaust them. But maybe tonight, Pastor, we can maybe look at one, if not two, if maybe time allows us. Just one or two, and the Lord gonna bless us.
Amen.
I want to remind you before I invite Pastor to just give us a few thoughts that we are going to share tonight.
Yes.
That please, share this broadcast.
Share it.
Especially if you know someone who is married, somebody who is there in a family, you're gonna share this right now.
Amen.
So we want to learn tonight, what are these causes of lack of Twatwa? There are so many, can mention one or two tonight.
Yes.
And if we get more time, probably in our next broadcast, we're gonna mention much more.
Yes.
But before you do that, there's a scripture I would want to share with our viewers tonight. In the book of Proverbs, chapter 21 and verse 9. It's a scripture I don't want you to forget. So powerful.
Yes.
Proverbs chapter 21 and verse 9. I will quote, the word of God says, it is better to live in a corner of the housetop.
Yes.
It is better to live or to dwell in the corner of a housetop.
Yes.
This now amplified version, the one I am quoting.
Yes.
Yeah, this is on the flat oriented roof. Okay. Exposed to all kinds of weather. That is very, very serious.
Yes.
Can you imagine? Exposed to all kinds of weather. Kukinyesha, unanyeshewa. Jua ikiwaka, unachomwa. Kukiwa na baridi, ndio hiyo. Kukiwa na snow, ndio hiyo. You know, I'm trying to imagine exposed to all kinds of weather.
Yes.
That's, I'm reading the word of God. Than in a house shared with a nagging and quarrelsome and fault finding person. Wow.
Amen.
What a word. I'll repeat it again. It is better to dwell in a corner of the housetop, on the flat oriental roof, exposed to all kinds of weather, than to share a house, to share a room with a nagging and quarrelsome and fault finding person.
Wow.
We are talking about causes of, you know, lack of Twatwa in marriage.
Wonderful.
Pastor.
Yes.
The word of God is so powerful.
The word of God is so powerful.
Yes.
And that's why the Bible says very clearly in the book of 1 Corinthians 7 verse 1.
Yes.
That do not deprive each other unless with a consent. So that you can give yourself to prayer and then come quickly so that you don't give the devil a chance. But you find most of the couples deny each other sex because of lack of knowledge. The Bible says in the book of Hosea 4 verse 6 that God's people, the saved is the Christian, the born again, are destroyed not because the devil is powerful, but because they lack knowledge. And when you lack knowledge, then the enemy is likely to take advantage of that. And one of the things that the devil takes advantage of is through lack of knowing what to do when you have a challenge. And most of the times when couples get challenges, they don't know what to do. So you find they keep, you know, blaming one another for what has happened, and sometimes even sweeping the problem under the carpet. And at the end of the day, you find that your marriage, your relationship is getting cold. You are becoming more hostile to each other. You are not connecting emotionally because you have hurt each other. And it's very unfortunate that we hurt each other by our actions and we hurt each other by our words. Not knowing when you hurt your partner, you have hurt yourself. Because if I don't have peace, I also not give Pastor Munene peace, and vice versa is true.
Exactly.
So it is very important for us to know that the peace of your partner is also your peace. The joy of your partner is also your joy. And so when your sexual life is healthy, then every other area will be healthy. Because anytime your wife or your husband is emotionally hurt, you're not able to connect sexually.
Exactly.
You just find yourself repelling. Even when you go to do it, it will just be doing it for the sake of it. Not that you are really
for
there.
For duty.
Yeah, for duty or just doing it for the sake of it.
Exactly.
And there's nothing so tiring like doing sex or having Twatwa just because you want to fulfill your partner and get letting he or her get out of your way.
Exactly.
And I want to say that every marriage is susceptible to these, you know, we would call them dry spell or lack of sex. Many times, most of the families will suffer from this because there are many reasons why some are genuine, some are self-centered.
Exactly.
Others could be, you are not able to solve your problems, and by so doing, it affects your sexual life. Mm-hmm. And so most families are actually susceptible to this. Mm-hmm. And every couple and every marriage mm-hmm. must know how to make sure that they are connected to each other. Mm-hmm. And so there is no couple that has a perfect sexual life. Mm-hmm. It is important for people to know that.
Exactly.
No matter how good you are to mm-hmm. each other, mm-hmm. there is no couple that has a perfect mm-hmm. sexual life. Never be cheated. Mm-hmm. You keep learning. Every day is a day to learn mm-hmm. from one another so that you can be able to perfect. Mm-hmm. Because most of the times when we get married, mm-hmm. we think we know how mm-hmm. to do it. Mm-hmm. And you see, most of the times you do it your style. Mm-hmm. You don't do it the style of your, mm-hmm. partner,
of your partner.
Because you think you know. Mm-hmm. And you see, this know-it-all attitude has mm-hmm. destroyed so many families. Mm-hmm. And we need to be aware about that. Mm-hmm. That there's no marriage mm. or there's no couple that have a very perfect sexual life, and that's why such teachings are very important mm. to keep us adding us a little bit of what we know.
Exactly.
And so no matter how much you have experience mm. you've been married for 20 years 30 mm. years, you need mm. to learn something about sexuality mm. because things keep changing. Mm. The same girl mm. you are with mm. when you're marrying has yes. now had children.
Yes.
And soon some of us are also in menopause mm. you know, and others are also in andropause. Mm-hmm. Those who are men.
Yes.
So it is important for us to know the seasons and the times so that we should not allow lack of sex mm. just because of the situation that is surrounding us.
Exactly.
And so every marriage must know. Mm. Knowledge is very key. And that's knowledge. Why every Friday mm-hmm. we come to you to bring you knowledge mm. that is based on the word of God mm. and proper experiences, mm. you know, through the people of God, not mm. the worldly way, mm-hmm. not the demonic way, mm-hmm. but the godly way. Mm. How a normal marriage should actually be.
Amen.
And as Pastor has said, mm-hmm. he has given a very wonderful reason. Mm. One of the causes of lack of sex in marriage mm. is a nagging behavior. When you have a nagging behavior, mm-hmm. a man can have a nagging behavior and a woman can also have a nagging behavior.
Exactly.
Days are gone mm. when people used to think that nagging is only for women.
For women
we
only.
Also have men who nag. Mm. They keep giving excuses. Mm-hmm. They keep giving, you know, saying I am tired, mm. I am this, mm-hmm. I am fatigued. And men are also a victim of the same.
Exactly.
And so it is important for us to know that mm. constant harassing mm. someone, you mm. know, to do something, mm. you know, mm. you keep harassing mm-hmm. someone mm. or a repetitive behavior mm. that keeps on, you are pestering, you are bugging, mm. you are annoying, mm. you irritate, mm-hmm. and this becomes a continuous thing mm-hmm. can actually drain a couple mm-hmm. and make you feel like mm-hmm. you are not meant for mm-hmm. each other. Mm-hmm. But it's because you are dealing with your emotions mm-hmm. and you are not able to control your emotions mm-hmm. in such a way to accommodate the other person.
Your emotions, your feeling, mm-hmm. you know, all that.
Yes.
You know, your emotions, your mm-hmm. feeling, mm-hmm. the things that probably maybe you can see, mm-hmm. you can hear.
Yes.
So you become nagging. Exactly.
Yeah, because now you are feeling weary.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you mm-hmm. feel like your partner mm-hmm. is too much. Mm-hmm. You know, it can actually even happen sometimes even when there is also a genuine request. Mm-hmm. Your wife will request you to have sex, but you feel, mm-hmm. si tulifanya jana. Mm-hmm. See, this morning we had it. Mm-hmm. Why should she ask now? Mm-hmm. Or your husband. Mm-hmm. And some of the women will put pads and mm-hmm. say they are on their menses. Mm-hmm. Others will say they have headaches. Others will say they feel they are tired. Mm-hmm. Others, they'll give all these excuses. Yeah, and these excuses, when they mm-hmm. persist, mm-hmm. they can actually destroy your marriage, as you are joking. Mm-hmm. You know, people tend to not to take care of the little things. And at the end of the day, they can destroy your marriage. Mm-hmm. Because where do you want your husband mm-hmm. to go mm-hmm. when he feels that he needs you sexually? Mm-hmm. Where do you want your wife to go mm-hmm. when she feels that she needs you sexually? Mm-hmm. And one of the advantages of sex is that it relieves you from fatigue.
Exactly.
It relieves you from that stress, mm-hmm. that feeling of like you don't want, mm. because anytime you bond, mm. anytime you caress, mm. anytime you kiss, anytime you hold each other, mm. there is a hormone mm. that is produced within your body mm-hmm. called the oxytocin mm. that helps you to bond. Mm-hmm. And after you have bond, mm. during sexual intercourse, both of you, after reaching orgasm, mm-hmm. there's another hormone called endorphin,
yes.
that makes you relax. And so people don't know the benefit of having sex, you know, mm-hmm. in marriage, mm-hmm. and so they tend to push it away. Mm-hmm. Yet it is the mm-hmm. it is the medicine mm-hmm. to all what they are passing through. Mm-hmm. But because we don't have knowledge, mm-hmm. we tend to think we can only have sex when all of us are high. Mm-hmm. You know, when we
Which
are feeling,
is not the case.
You know, when we are feeling, we are really
high.
Sexual,
you need it, and
you need
all that.
It, you know. Yeah. But no, mm-hmm. it is unless mm-hmm. you have agreed. Mm-hmm. That's when you can actually, you know. you have agreed, that's when you can avoid. Mm-hmm. And so it is important for us to know that nagging, you know, creates a lot of impatience, even among a couple. When a husband nags and when a wife nags, then you become also selfish because you are obeying what you are feeling and you don't care the feeling of your partner, whether they need you at that time or not. So at the end of the day, you find it brings a lot of anger. And that's why you find most of the people have a lot of anger in marriage because you are angry yesterday. Excuses. So at the end of the day, your tension inakupema hasira,
and you're frustrated,
and you
also
feel frustrated,
you know,
and so at the end of the day, not knowing,
and that, irritable,
you know, just feel you are fed up, and you wonder, for how long will you keep on begging, for how long will you keep on telling your husband you want this, you know. And sometimes women, we feel so frustrated, but we are not able to tell you guys that we want to have Twatwa, and that, because there are times the cycle of a woman, there are times when we are ovulating, we just feel we want it, we just feel you just want it, and that's when your man is telling you, me, I'm feeling so tired, hati my dear, we got a headache. So you are wondering, sasa amekuja na ma headaches, see, tufanye tu, your headache itapotea, because one of the advantages of sex is a painkiller, and people don't know that
it is a
painkiller.
That is powerful.
It's able to deal with you know if we go to the science, the neurometers that sense the pain, the receptors, it is able to calm them down and produce another hormone that makes you relax. So all these things are very important for every person who is in marriage to understand, because when you don't understand them, you'll be led by what you're feeling and what you think, and at the end of the day, you hurt your partner in the name that hukuona jisikia, sijisiki.
And that is very common among the couples.
Very common.
Mamba sijisiki, haujisiki. So by the end of the day, when we live in that kind of vacuum, ni mambo ya kujisikia. And I think love making or Twatwa has got nothing to do with kujisikia. It's an issue of like a calling. It's an issue of a responsibility, you know, because no one can do that on your behalf. We say you can't delegate Twatwa to anyone. Can you imagine? You can delegate all other responsibility, even your children, to be taken care by somebody, maybe if you are away, to be taken maybe somewhere, but you cannot delegate this issue of love making. It is a personal responsibility. Moment you neglect it, everybody gets frustrated. Everybody gets, you know, irritated. And I think that is something that many people they need to understand, that when we start now giving excuses, they take us the wrong direction. You know, and I always tell people that excuses will cut your blessing short. And many, many people, they have destroyed their marriages. They have destroyed their families just because of mere excuses, which are neither here or there. You know, so I tend to feel that, you know, anytime one keep on nagging and all that, one thing that also happened, Pastor, it leads to low self-esteem because of nagging. You know, all the time you're nagging, you
drain each other.
You drain each other and all that.
Each other negatively.
Exactly. And when there's too much of nagging, you find that even the issue of Twatwa cannot be done in a good way or in a good environment.
Oh, yes.
So it's like you are reducing sexual attraction because of nagging. And we are saying nagging is both with the men
and with women.
And with women.
Yeah.
Days are gone when we used to say there is only one partner who can do that. That is not so anymore. So I think that we need to ask ourselves, what are some of the things that we need to learn or the remedy of nagging, so that we can be able to come out of this, so that we can improve our relationship and marriage.
Wow.
Exactly.
I think one of the remedies of nagging is to operate in the truth.
Wow.
Yeah.
Operate
in the truth.
In the truth.
Yes.
You shall know the truth, and the truth will set you free.
Amen. So operate in the truth. Speak the truth. So that now you don't leave your partner guessing. why are you not giving in to sex? Speak the truth. You get that.
Yeah.
But don't leave each other in suspense. I don't know why yesterday it never happened. You told me tomorrow morning. Then you wake up very early in the morning and leave me. You come again in the evening and give excuse you're tired. Then again you disappear in the morning. You see, speak the truth. When you find yourself not being able to perform as a couple, we are not in a competition. Speak out the truth. Say exactly what is helping. You could be surprised that most of the times the person who has your solution is your partner. They're able to understand you. They're able to relieve that stress. They're able to give you a way forward. But when you keep quiet, you create more tension between yourself.
Wow.
So learn to speak your mind out.
Learn to speak your mind out.
Learn to speak the truth to each other.
Exactly.
So that now you are walking in transparency. You are walking in truth. I don't have any suspicion. And you see now, when you don't walk in the truth, it brings mistrust.
Yes.
Because if you keep giving me excuses, I keep on giving you excuses, and you keep giving me excuses, we are destroying this marriage in the name of excuses. So why don't we speak the truth? My wife, I'm feeling put on by 1, 2, 3 things. My husband, this is the area. And thank God we have the phone. You can text, you can WhatsApp, you can Messenger. You know, all these things we have means we can communicate. You can even get someone whom your husband or your wife respect and honors. Let them guide you.
Wow, so like that
you
a mentor.
Oh, yes. So that you can be able to deal with this confusion that is there. So it is good. And sometimes, Pastor, nagging appears very harmless. Munaka ni kama, munaski ni kama. I don't know how to put it. Ni kama unasikizana na unajua kabisa msikizani. Your one partner is not okay.
Yes.
And you are able to tell when your partner is not satisfied with you. So nagging, it looks harmless, but let me tell you the truth. And it looks like it's a very genuine concern, but it is not supposed to be so.
Exactly.
Don't nag your partner. Tell them the truth. The truth about why you are not able to rise up to the occasion, you know. And the worst scenario is because this dry spell and lack of sex has led so many separation and divorce and even extramarital affairs outside, because we have always told you that nature does not allow
vacuum.
So when you don't fulfill each other, as the Bible says in the book of 1 Corinthians 7, that do not deprive each other. Musinyimane. That's what the Bible says. Musinyimane.
Do not. And that's the word of God.
So that means you can. If you hear do not, it means you can also purpose to do. It is in your power. To deny, and it is in your power not to deny.
Exactly.
But what will make me not deny my husband or my wife sex is because I have the knowledge, and this knowledge is based on the truth that we have sexual needs, a man has sexual needs, and a wife has sexual needs, and the two of you must cooperate, the two of you must agree on the way forward. But it's unfortunate that every other thing is discussed in marriage apart from sex, and you see, that's the area that is mostly attacked.
Actually, I'm just thinking, Pastor.
Yes.
That the reason why marriage is there, the reason why a man and a woman will come together, it is only the first major reason. It is Twatwa.
Very true.
Actually, that is the highest reason for marriage. And I'll repeat again. That is the highest reason for marriage.
Yes.
Twatwa or love making. That is why people get married.
It's one of the reasons, because you also have intimacy.
Yes.
You also have, you know, companionship.
Yes.
But all that
is more
bond. It's like it's knit together.
Exactly.
It's strengthened
by
your sexual intimacy.
Exactly.
Yeah, because just like we have food that we eat for our physical body, sex is food for marriage.
Sex is food
for marriage.
For marriage.
Never forget
Amen.
That.
Amen.
Yeah,
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Yes.
So just like we eat food to get strength, to be able to go to work, to be able to do a few things, to be able to do all these things that we do. And if you don't eat and drink, you're not going to have strength
to work.
So the same thing must be in your mind, that sex is the food for marriage.
Sex is
the food for marriage.
Other
people will say communication is the food, but let me tell you the truth. Sex is the real food for marriage. So we must make sure that this food is okay to both of us.
Yes.
How do we know this? By walking in the truth. The truth of what is the sexual drive of your wife? What is the sexual drive of your husband? You get, because we differently have different appetites. But I always say it is important for you to make sure as a husband that you're satisfying your wife, you're satisfying your husband, so that now there is no other. You better have a misunderstanding on finances. You better have a misunderstanding on your communication, but not have a misunderstanding when it comes to sex.
That is powerful.
Because that's where the enemy strikes most.
That is very key.
Because even if we had a misunderstanding with you on communication,
yes,
but our sexual life is okay, there's no way sexually transmitted diseases can come because we don't have communication. There's no way sexually transmitted diseases, chronic, and those are the diseases that have no even cure. Let's even talk about the HIV. But it can come because I denied you sex and you went outside, you brought a disease.
Wow.
You know, even hepatitis B, because now we also have all these diseases that have now come that have are not treatable, but as they are sexually transmitted. You can give me, you know, what do you call these things? They are warts, sexual warts, herpes. There are some things that grow around the private parts. All these diseases are contracted because someone went out because they felt they are not satisfied.
Yes.
And you see, it's unfortunate that if I don't satisfy, not many couples are able to sit down and even text each other and tell each other, my dear, I think you're depriving me. You're denying me. My God, you were right. So most people opt to keep quiet, look like everything is okay, Pastor, and just sneak out.
And could this be the reason why there's a lot of problems in marriage?
Yes.
Because people are talking on so many other things. They'll talk about children, they'll talk about business, they'll talk about school fees,
parents,
you know, buying the products, they'll talk about building
investments,
but they don't talk about the reason why they came together.
Yes.
Which is, of course, to satisfy each other. You know, the Bible says that a man shall leave his parents, shall be joined to his wife, and they shall be one, shall give to his wife, they shall become one.
One flesh.
And whether we agree or not, see, the more we shy away
from sex,
from speaking about sex
in marriage,
the more the enemy will get an opportunity to destroy our families, our marriages. And that's why you realize that when someone speaks about this language, especially if you are born again, you are termed to be like you are naughty,
you have a vaga language, unakaa ni kama uelewi, you know,
exactly.
All these things, you look funny.
Yeah.
Yes, but when you talk about money, when you talk about communication, people feel okay.
Exactly.
But look at it, Pastor.
Yeah.
The same area that most couples are struggling with is the same area our young people are struggling with. It's the same area that our children are struggling with. Because even if you don't talk about sex, we have teenage pregnancies. Even if we don't talk about sex, we have, you know, youth getting pregnant.
Yes.
You get that?
Yes.
Why? This is an area we have shied off. But it is a serious need. So at the end of the day, you find that even if we don't talk to our children about it, they will still get information from the internet. And the information that you are going to get will teach them on how early sex is good, how masturbation is good, you know?
Wow.
They will be taught all these worldly standards
from the internet.
And so when you are coming as a parent, you find your daughter and your son has already indulged themselves into sexual acts, and you are like, oh my goodness, when did my son know this?
Yeah.
When did my daughter know this? But you are the one who shied off from introducing the basics.
Yes.
So it's a really, I don't know whether it's a stronghold.
Yes, it is a stronghold
in Africa.
It's a stronghold.
Because it's not so in the Western. It's not so in the Euro. But when it comes to Africa, it's like we are bound. It's a taboo. You should not talk about sex. It should not be mentioned, especially by the clergy. But this is the same organs.
Yes.
We were born with them.
Yes.
We grew up with them.
Yes.
How do we control our sexual appetites? And that's why we tell we should teach our children the basics on how to maintain, you know, to remain chaste
until
the right time of their marriage.
I'm just thinking, Pastor, that when you listen to most of the couples, people who are married, you realize when they are talking to us, one thing that is key, where they always rotate about almost 100%, It is about Twatwa. Mm-hmm. That is where actually all the problems are. Mm. You find that, you know, many people they have got all these other things. Mm-hmm. But you realize that, you know, Pastor, mm-hmm. I could not take it anymore.
Yes.
When I realized mm-hmm. my husband mm-hmm. has got a side cheek.
Oh, yes.
When I realized my wife mm. is, you know,
having another man
mm-hmm. so that man felt so betrayed mm. that woman felt so betrayed mm. You know, you can forgive on anything else,
yes,
but this sin of adultery,
so you painful. Know
it is so painful mm. when you realize that you are giving all in all mm. and you have not denied this person anything mm. and yet they are still going outside mm. so you feel you are like what is it that you have not done mm-hmm. that you're supposed to do mm. what is it that you have not given?
Yes.
And you have given all in all. Mm. And so this is actually a monster in our society. Mm. And we must stand together
yes.
with the men of God mm. and the women of God.
Oh, yes.
And first I want to thank God because we mm. have got a clergy mm. that have come up.
Yes.
Bishops, pastors, mm. men of God
oh, yes.
who are saying, yes, Pastor, mm. this is what we should do. Mm. Because if we don't speak about it,
yes,
we
know the
politicians teach our society.
No.
Who will teach it? Mm-hmm. The business community.
They cannot teach about
it. They will not teach about it. Mm-hmm. Who will not teach it? Mm-hmm. The pilots, they will not teach it.
They will not teach it.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So we, people who are called, mm-hmm. and we understand the truth, mm-hmm. we must stand out
yes.
and say enough is enough.
Yes.
And fight the enemy. Mm-hmm. Because this is the work of the devil. Mm-hmm.